गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मोहम्मद मसलियुद्दीन, पीजीटी इन सिविक्स, तेलंगाना स्टेट मॉडल स्कूल कलवाला, मंडल के सुंदरम एंड डिस्ट्रिक्ट मोहब्बत। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू 9th क्लास सोशल स्टडीज इंग्लिश मीडियम, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड सोशल चेंज। दिस लेसन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू 3 पार्ट्स। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू पार्ट ए। So this lesson, I divided this lesson into structures. Before going to learn this lesson, industrialization and social change, it was divided by some structures. In these structures, one is objectives of the study. What will you get? What will you understand after going through this lesson? And after that, introduction and definition of the lesson, and after that, why industrialization only developed in England, not in other countries, and the availability of iron, coal, and minerals like and raw material, and after that, the workers availability in England, and abundant resources and water resources, and there is no scarcity of water in England. So these are the things, these are the good positive things to England to develop more in industrialization. So that's why before I am going to start this lesson, I would like to tell the structure here. Main the thing is, first you are going to learn about the objectives of the lesson, and after that here introduction and definition of this industrialization, and after that you are going to learn why was Britain only important. These we are going to discuss in the lessons. So,
note down this.
Dear students, today I am going to discuss the introduction of industrialization and the definition of industrialization also. Now let us discuss the industrialization has happened in England. So these words, economy and industry, words have changed the England during the 1780 to 1850. The economy and industry changed England during 1780 to 1850. Here, the first time industrialization, industrial revolution, the first time the word used by two European scholars by name Georges Bicklet of France and Frederick Engels of German. These both scholars of European countries, they used this industrial revolution word first time. And after that, Arnold Toynbee, an English professor, in his books, he used this word first time in English, this industrial revolution. Here, what is the meaning of industrialization? Industrialization is a period of social economic change of human being, from transformation from this agrarian society to industrial society. So the easy definition of this industrialization is, industrialization is a process of using machines for the upliftment of industries and for the purpose of manufacturing of the raw material also. So that's why here industrialization has been developed and emerged in England only. Okay, here England, if you look at the world map, if you look this atlas, you take one atlas, in this atlas you can get world map. If you take this European political map, here it is this England is there. Here England is a country that is a part of United Kingdoms. Here Wales and Scotland also there. Here Wales, it is England shares the boundaries with the Wales to west side, and Scotland to the north side. Scotland, Wales, or England, these are ruled by one monarch. So that's why it was very easy to them and unified to do development of this industrialization. Okay, here moreover, the industrialization depends on the geographical conditions of the country also. Okay. The fourth reason is the bank facilities for the raising of the capital for the purpose of building these industries and building of the industry and manufacturing purpose. In England, more bank facilities were there. Bank of London and London Stock Exchange, these were played a vital role in establishing the loans and creating and raising the money for the purpose of establishing industries also. That was also very useful. Another reason, another one is there. Here, availability of workers also. And more manpower was there in England. Not only in England, from other countries also, most of the workers migrated to England for the purpose of, for the sake of employment. Here, these in England, willing to work, most of the people, most of the workers, they were willing to work in the factories of England. Next one, for all these things, England was called workshop of the world. So, everything was available, abundant resources were there, raw material was there, and water facility is there, and everything is available, even harbor, even the workers, everything was available in England for the development of industrialization. Not only that, so that's why England was called workshop of the world, and most of the persons, they worked in England for the purpose of their employment. And in Scotland, Wales, all the surrounding countries, in France, Germany, all the people, they have taken the inspiration of this England. These are the reasons. Earlier we learnt the process of iron smelting in traditional method. It was very heavy, costly, and more difficult, and it was inconvenient to smelt the iron from the process of all these coal or charcoal. These are very difficult and very tough activity. So that's why very scientific method has been adopted in England. If you take example of this discovery in England. Here, Darby's of Shropshire. Darby's of Shropshire means these persons are the iron masters in England. Iron masters. Grandfather, father, and son, these persons, they are the iron masters. They did very good activities for the development of this smelting process in an easy method. If you take example of Abraham Darwis, he discovered the coke with a good method. He discovered the coke and which produces high temperature and here in order to heat the iron. Next one, the coke is produced from the coal, and where coal is being removed, sulfur and impurities. And next, this coke gave a revolutionary change, and coke has displaced instead of charcoal. Means charcoal is very difficult to get and occurs deforestation here, but coke is very easy to consumable. These are the
good methods and scientific methods to get the iron in a good way. Second Abris and Henry Cart also did a great contribution for the welfare of this industry. For the purpose of using these furnace and this metal for the using all the activities of home activities or home purpose, they used a science and technology method. So that's why the industry has developed in England more. Dear students, the remaining chapter we are going to continue in part B. Up to that, stay home and stay safe and do the activities and do the project also. The project is very useful to you. What are the consequences of industrialization and impact of industrialization in rural areas also?